guys, it's Haff. I am back again, and this is the update for my Project Pan Roulette collab that I'm doing with, let's see if I can get this right this time, Connie, Zelma, Liz, and Leah. I think I got them all. They'll all be linked down below as usual. First of all, as I usually do, I will go through the things that I had already finished up to this point. So this is a year-long collab. We started on the 1st of November last year, and it will run to the 1st of November this year. So, things that I have used up. The Urban Skincare Co. Infused Body Balm. The Elf Lip Exfoliator. This is the original one. I don't particularly like this one. I want to try out the mint one, the peppermint one that I've got now. The Manicare Cuticle Therapy, the Nivea Night Cream, it's all finished up. The Pond's BB Miracle, did finally finish this, took me longer than I was expecting. The Liquid Face Primer I got rid of because it's nasty. And the... This had the Sukin's Skin Exfoliator in it. I've put something else in it now. But that one was finished as well. So, on to everything else. I technically have not finished anything this month, but I will be adding a new one in because one of them is basically like one use away from being finished. So, the bronzer I have in here, this is the Avon Arabian Glow Bronzing Pearls. This is one of those ones that it's not really going to show, like, much progress until it's, like, near done, because that's just not how that product is. But I've been using it and, you know, pretty much enjoying it, so I'm not... too upset. Next one is a highlighter. This is the Natio Enhancer in Warm Day. It probably looks exactly the same. There is a slight dent forming in the middle there. It's been pretty slow progress on that one. My oldest blush, Maybelline Wild Blossom, another product that pretty much looks exactly the same. It is flattened out a bit. That's another one of those ones you're not going to notice until I actually hit pan on it, really. Okay, so the product that I'd only buy on sale is the Sèche Vite. I'm basically just filling a small bottle. So we are now down to here. We were all the way up here. Down to there. There's probably two more refills in this before it's done. It's not a complete bottle refill. I basically top my bottle up when it starts to get a little bit thick, which is the best thing to do with Sèche Vite. The product that I'm basically finished with and will be pulling a new one for is the BYS HD Micro Finishing Powder. It's all the way down here. It's getting harder and harder to get it out of the packaging. I'm going to have to pop the sifter off of it. There's probably at most two uses left in there, if that. There's like almost nothing left in there. So, I'm going to pull a new product for that one because it's, I'll definitely finish it this month. Provided, of course, I wear makeup. The next one is the Rimmel Scandalize in Bright Blue. I think I've only used this once. There's a little tiny movement of my line So that's where we were last time, that's where we are now. Most of that movement is because I sharpened it. Then we have the Australis finishing spray. That is all the way down there. I seriously should be able to finish that this month. In fact, if I just wore makeup like twice, I reckon that one would be done. It's a bit like the BYS HD thing. I think I'll probably pull another one for that as well, just because it is so, like, knowing how much I use it, that'll be gone in the same time that the BYS one is actually done. So yeah, I'll be pulling another two. The 11 Miracle Hair Treatment. I believe I'm about there. It's actually really hard to see. There's like so little product left in it. But you don't need a whole lot. So it might be done this month, but then it might not, because I don't really wash my hair more than a couple of times a week. The lip gloss in from Cargo in Sahara, which looks like that. I have not put a new mark on this one because it doesn't look like it's actually moved too much. I think I've only worn it like once or twice, if that. Like, I wore it today. But yeah. Then we have the Clean Colour Lipstick in Sealed Secret. I haven't actually worn that this month, so it doesn't look any different and its line hasn't moved or anything. The favourite highlighter to hit pan in, yes, I have two highlighters in this project. This is the Lorac Perfectly Lit Luminous. This will look exactly the same as it did last time. I've used it like twice. It won't look any different. I'm trying to get through the Nadia one first. The product that you always love, I have the... I have eyeshadow going everywhere. I have the LA Colors eyeshadow. What I'm working on is this one here. It's actually not that far away from actually, I don't know if you can tell in the center, but it's not that far away from actually hitting pan in this one here. So, but I actually want to use it all up. So that one could take a little bit longer, but I'm still enjoying using it. I'm not complaining. Last time I put in this eye cream, which is the Natural Instincts eye cream. I now have black eyeshadow all over me. It hasn't really moved very much. I think my mark might have been wrong last time. But I was using another eye cream that's like was a sample size that was in another project. So that one hasn't had as much attention. And the last thing from last time was the Anika Pure Primer. Used it a couple of times, it's fine. I don't think it likes the current foundation I'm using. I don't think I like the current foundation I'm using. But it seems fine. But I have no idea where it is. But it was full when I started, so there's heaps to go on that one. So, I am going to put two more out of this lovely box of items. Hopefully I won't get something horrendous. Just mix them up a bit first. We have one. And two. And the two that I have pulled out. A product out of your comfort zone. And a full size product. Okay, I will go find a couple of things and then I'll be back. Okay, I am back for my full-size product. I have this brand new Lacura Deep Cleansing Seaweed Facial Scrub, which I bought just the other day. It's still safety sealed and everything. I'm using kind of another scrubby thing at the moment, but I'll just rotate between the two of them. I have no idea what this is like because I've never used it before. I'm sure it will be fine though. So, yeah, that is going to be the full-size product. Brand new, never been used. The product out of my comfort zone. I've added in another lipstick, which is probably slightly crazy because I have lots of lipsticks in lots of different projects. But this one is actually a nude. And if you know me, I don't really wear nude lipstick. I tend to wear more of a bolder colour. This one is the Kate by Rimmel in 45, which looks like that in the tube. And looks like that on my hand. This is certainly not something that I would generally reach for because it is very light for my comfort. Yeah, so that is going to be my product out of my comfort zone. This is one I got from a friend, so it's only got probably 2/3 of the product in it anyway. So that is those two products. So this has been my update. This is update number 4 for this particular project. The other ladies that I'm collabing with will be listed down below, so make sure you go and check all of them out. And if you're coming from one of them, hello. If you want to subscribe, click the button down there, leave me a thumbs up if you like these kind of videos, and leave me a comment down below. I try to respond to all comments, and I'll see you in my next video. See ya.